And hello, fellow Tanker Space Bandit here with another episode of World of Tanks. And today we are in a tier 9 German heavy tank E75. Yes, guys, I don't remember the last time you've seen this tank on my channel. It must be a long, long time ago. There was a day when I played this tank religiously, almost every day. I used to love this tank like there is no tomorrow. And this tank, boys and girls, is absolutely fantastic when it comes to its armor. Actually, at tier 9, I think this tank is even better than E100 at tier 10. And we'll probably do a little bit of comparison between that and E100. And I will have some E100 gameplay for you on this channel shortly. Anyway, today belongs to E75, so today I have two games for you guys. But before we jump into the replays, let's take a look at the stats of this tank quite quickly and see what it's good at. So in order to get into E75, you have to grind through the line of Tiger 1, Tiger 2, which will get you to E75, and then the E100. So that line is quite pleasant to play, to be honest. I mean, even Tiger 1 at tier 7 and Tiger 2 at tier 8 are pretty good vehicles, and then you get this beast, which is E75 at tier 9. E100 at tier 10 is not as dominating as it used to be back in the day when there was only IS-7 and E100. As far as tier 10 goes, this tank was devastating on a battlefield, but nowadays this tank is actually really nothing to be concerned about. I mean, everyone loads heat rounds in order to deal with E100, and because of the flat surface of the turret, that area can be easily penned with heat rounds. But anyway, let's get back to E75, and E75 by itself has really incredible armor. The whole armor on this tank is 160 millimeters on the front plate, which is angled quite nicely. And if you slope this tank at about, you know, 30-35 degrees and you cover your bottom plate, you can bounce a lot of shells with this hull, to be honest. Look at this lag, it's freaking ridiculous. My internet's just bad. I have really good internet on paper, guys, but I don't know what the crap is my provider doing with my connection. I have no clue, and I've realized lately that it's not actually wargaming, that is my connection, it's screwing shit up. I need to get to the bottom of this. Going back to the armor, even tier 10s are gonna have trouble penetrating this hull every once in a while. Obviously, tank destroyers with big guns will be able to go through your front hull regardless. But before you get into the battle, I would suggest that you look on the team distribution list and figure out how many tank destroyers you're going to deal with. And if you run into them, what is your plan B? That's what you have to keep in mind. As far as turret armor goes, you do have 252 millimeters of armor on the front. There is a little bit of a flat area at the front around the gun mantlet, and you're going to have the same thing with the Tiger 2, but that area is not that easy to pen, to be honest. It's extremely hard to hit, especially if you keep moving back and forth and wiggle your turret. Yeah, it will be difficult to hit. So people are either gonna try to hit you in this area, or they will try to hit you in a cupola, which is also not that well armored. Now, some time ago, E75 got a speed buff. I think it used to go up to 35 kilometers an hour, but nowadays it goes to 40 kilometers an hour. And if you go downhill, you actually can go even faster than that. So that speed buff will allow you to play this tank more as a heavy medium, to be honest. But with the armor that it has, it can be played both ways, even at tier 10. The biggest problem with this tank, I guess, is its top gun. Even though it punches a huge alpha per shell, which is at about 490 HP, quite incredible if you ask me, because quite often you'll be rolling over 500 with this gun. The one big problem with the gun itself is the fact that the aim time is at about 2.9 seconds and the reload time is quite long at about, well, my reload is at about close to 13 seconds with the rammer and pretty decent crew. So that's what you're gonna run into. Also, accuracy at 0.38 is not the best. So this gun will shoot potatoes every once in a while. So it's probably best if you play this tank more close up than far away, because if you snipe, yeah, you're gonna have trouble hitting target, especially at long distance. Gun depression at minus 8 degrees is not bad at all, actually, for this tank. And if you angle your armor properly and use your minus 8 degrees of gun depression, yeah, this tank will be hard to penetrate. View range on this tank is 400 meters, which is quite incredible, to be honest, as well. So if you have all your view range perks, such as recon and situational awareness, you definitely won't be outspotted in this tank, except for light tanks and medium tanks that have view range of 420. but you can easily max out the view range on this tank with crew skills and the equipment. As far as shell penetration goes, you get 246 millimeters of penetration on standard shells, which is not that great, as you probably end up using premium shells quite often, especially if you're brawling in your face, up close and personal. But the premium shells on this tank are APCR rounds, and they have 311 millimeters of pen, which is pretty much good enough to go through turret cheek of an A100, for instance. So yeah, with that penetration, you should have no trouble at tier 10. Anyway, that's enough about the tank stats. Let's jump into the replays and see what we've done so far. So it looks like we managed to blabber about the tank for like most of this video, most of this game anyway, and we didn't concentrate on the game. However, on Overlord, if you take the beach, and that's what happened here, the opposing team sent most of their tanks to the beach. Yeah, prepare to lose the game, because beach is low ground. You want to fight for the high ground, which is, you know, anything but the beach, to be honest. Even if you fight for the center, it's better than fighting for the beach, and you should be able to win the game. Now, we faced very heavily armored tier 10, which is Panzer 7, and we were able to go through his lower plate. We also faced T-54E1, which doesn't have that tough of an armor. But big takeaway from this game, I guess, it's even without premium account, and I didn't have premium in this game, I was able to make credits. I made, what, 20,000 credits shooting quite a few APCR shells. So yeah, that's what this tank is good at. Even if you use premium shells, you still be able to make credits if you don't have premium account. So that's actually kind of fantastic. Anyway, we finished on top of the team with 1691 base XP. We had 5 kills with 4.3k damage. Nothing spectacular for this tank, to be honest. 4.3k damage is very little. It's above average game, but I remember back in the day I could easily do 5k in this tank quite often. So second game will be a little bit higher damage, so let's jump into that, and this time let's focus on the game instead of blabber about the tank for, you know, three quarters of the game. So as you've probably noticed, the second game we are a top tier, and not only that, our matchmaking is absolutely fantastic. We have only 3 tier 9s on my side and 3 tier 9s on the opposing side, and no artillery in play. Isn't that a treat? That is absolutely a treat. I don't get games like that quite often, guys, so I gotta take it in. Especially lately, my E75 matchmaking has been absolutely brutal, playing mostly tier 10s, and my teams have been horrific. So I rarely play this tank anymore, to be honest, because of that. But in this situation, I got a treat. So since I got a treat, you gotta take advantage of the situation. So what am I gonna do is I'm gonna go in the center of this map and play it like a medium tank. Use my view range. Unfortunately, the sniping ability is not the greatest on this tank, so I will miss some shots. And because I'm not used to shell velocity of this tank, I missed my first shell on the IS-3, which should have been an easy pen right there. We see this VK right here. We're gonna try to put a shell into him, but he's hiding into cover, so we can't really have a shot at him. As you can see, I'm not really even hiding because I'm a top tier. Anybody like this Panther here, or Crafts Panther, won't be able to pen me very easily. This guy's probably loaded premium rounds and he's going through me right now, but all of a sudden I see this Type 4 Heavy. You know, I'm afraid of his big gun, so I'm gonna drop back into cover, at least get away from his gun so I can still shoot at everybody else. Now this guy, I don't know what the hell he's doing. Why is he sitting in one spot just waiting to be shot at? I have no idea. Guys, don't play your tanks like that. Hide into cover, make it difficult for me to hit you. Side scrape, you know, like Crafts Panther maybe doesn't have the greatest armor, but if you side scrape it a little bit, you should still be able to bounce some shells. Here we put a shell into Type 4 Heavy, who is crossing right now. As you can see, I'm unspotted. I'm from behind the bushes firing, but all of a sudden I get spotted because the light tank behind me at D4 started yellowing, so now he spots me at the same time. So I'm back to wiggling the tank here, and we're gonna try to put one more shell into this Crafts Panther before we pull back. So that's what we're gonna do. Type 4 Heavy is moving at this point. He's not paying attention to me, but now that he stops and he starts aiming his gun, I really do not want to throw away hit points. So I back out behind the building. I started side scraping here. We're gonna try to hit his weak spot here at the corner of the front plate, but we weren't able to pen that. So we're gonna swap to APCR rounds now, because I didn't know whether he was gonna stay in that position or move forward, but it looks like he's moving forward towards the town. Anyway, we're gonna still play it aggressive through the middle here. We still see a shot at the Type 4, and here we trade. Unfortunately, he was looking at me. I thought he wasn't gonna be paying attention to me, but he was. So we put a shell into him. But now I think, yeah, he progressed further, so he doesn't have any more shots at me. I was looking for a shot at this Crafts Panther. I couldn't see anything there. So now, once the shots are gonna be gone, one more shot at Crafts Panther right there. That was pretty well aimed, but it missed. So this gun, you'll see, that's what it's gonna do at long distance. It's just not gonna hit shots reliably, that's for sure. Anyway, we're gonna head down to town right now because we need to get rid of that Type 4 Heavy. In the meantime, we see this IS-3, so we put a shell into him, and we're gonna move forward towards the town because Type 4 Heavy is a threat. We need to take him out of the game. Now, take a look at this guy. You don't play tanks like this, guys. You don't play your tanks backwards, especially in an OP tank like this. If you face your frontal armor in that tank, the Chrysler K, man, that tank is hard to penetrate. But if you show your ass just like that, I mean, everyone will be able to pen you. I don't know what that guy was doing. Anyway, so as you can see, the game is close. At this point, I want to clear this flank. So I want to scoot back here. I want to take care of that heavy tank that's on my left. At the same time, I see in the corner of my eye on the map that there's a couple heavy tanks and a light tank in location E7, E8. So I'm trying to run away from these guys, but I get tracked here. So I'm using my repair kit because I do not want to lose my HP. So I want to go forward, go behind the building here so they don't have shots at me. At the same time, I am at 1v1 with this Tiger P, and he raised his gun in the air because he knows this is the end of his lifetime. He's going to have a hard time panning me. So we put a shell into his cupola and we take him out of the game. Now we're going to turn around because we know the flank is clear now. So now we're going to turn around and face these guys to see if they come from behind the building, so we can engage him. But at the same time, no one's coming out. This light tank is sitting right here. And again, I don't know what this light tank was doing. If he was a smarter player, he should have been chasing me, sitting on my ass while I was engaging Tiger P. This guy could have been hitting me in the ass and getting me down in health, and he's just run off. I don't know the players, you know, nowadays, guys. Like, some of this stuff, it just doesn't make any sense. Like, here in a split second, I'll show you what I'm talking about here. So I'm going after this light tank, right? I say, basically requesting fire at this guy, but at the same time, I see my Scorpion running away. I know he's only one hit, but why is he running away? He could have flanked the heavy tank that I just hit and taken him out of the game, yet he decided to run off on the open street so that the guy could easily hit him. I don't really understand that. I also don't understand this light tank sitting here. He should have run off by now. He should have been gone, long gone. Last thing you want to do is engage E75, unless he would have came to my side and tried to hit me in the side. If you sit close by E75, maybe if you're not tall enough, I would have trouble maybe hitting you with my gun. But even in that situation, E75 has pretty good gun depression, so I would be able to hit him regardless. So yeah, I don't understand some of these players nowadays and these teams. A lot of players don't know what they're doing on the field, and this game is a very good example of that, because it was definitely way too easy for me in this situation. And some of the decisions, even on my team's side, were kind of weird, you know. I don't know how we won this game, because we were pretty much stuck in one area of the map. We lost the other flank as well. Well, now we won, but initially we lost it. So we pushed through. Anyway, this is the time for me to get final damage, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna fully aim this shot so we can hit it and get ourselves over 5k damage. So it's already a relatively good game. Now we're gonna try to hit another one here to get ourselves a little bit higher in damage, but this guy gets hit before I can hit him. We still take him out of the game. So still a nice game for E75, and a top tier like this, E75 is just a killer. It's a beast. I mean, you cannot throw your tank away, so you have to be still careful how you're engaging your position and make sure that you still have some cover. You have some tanks that are covering you, that are around you in case you are in trouble, they can help you. But other than that, if you don't let anyone get to your side, Yeah, it's easy peasy. You're gonna plow through the opposition like there's no tomorrow. Anyway, we finished the game with 5.4k damage, 5 kills, mastery ace tanker. We maintain our 2 mark status. We had a steel wall medal. We had 5 kills. Quite a fantastic game with over 1700 base XP and 6 medals. Anyway, guys, that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. E100 is coming up next. That's it for today. Until next time, happy tanking, Space Bandit checking out.